Now there's good life advice and there's bad life advice. For example, you could spend the next 30 years of your life paying off your mortgage, but you could also rob a bank, pay it off, and get only 10. Or instead of doing your taxes annually, which is just once a year, do them quarterly instead, which is once every 25 years. Or better yet, pay zero for your taxes by always selling your stocks at a loss. Tax loss harvesting, done right. No, just kidding. Don't follow any of that advice, but none of that advice is as bad as this. Check this out. It's a girl. All of that belongs in Bad Life Pro Tips. So today we're talking about the stock market and how to invest in green companies and be socially responsible with our investing. And if you're somebody who doesn't think that we need to do that, that's okay, because I'll share with you a stock that has outperformed the golden standard of index investing. But wait, I got one more. It's a girl. Just kidding. It's a boy. 2020, so confusing. Hi, my name is Andrei Jikh. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're staying safe from boredom. But if you click this video, then it's probably too late. But now that you're here, I wanted to talk about green investing and being socially responsible with our money, because the people in California are coming here to Las Vegas. That's because they decided to have a gender reveal party, and that set the entire state on fire, and that cloud of smoke traveled all the way to Vegas. Our entire sky was completely orange and toxic, and that cloud went as far as Canada and Montana. So that's pretty bad, and that made me think of this video idea. And I realize this is a pretty controversial topic that not everybody believes in, but I do think that at least in the future, this is going to be one of the biggest issues facing our generation, to find a solution to what seems to be like an invisible problem. It's one of those things that you don't actually see happening in front of you, but it's there. It's just hard to see. It's almost like watching trees or mountains grow. We know it's happening. It's just our brains were never evolved enough to perceive such slow passages of time. But what if we finally agreed on something for once and we wanted to invest socially, responsibly, and vote with our money? This is the way. It's called the ESG structure model, and it stands for economic, social, and governance. And I know that sounds like a lot of complicated words, but I promise it's really easy to understand. When we invest, the goal is to combine the normal metrics along with this ESG rating, of which there are three major ones. So for example, the first one is called the laggard, and it basically lags behind the entire industry. And these corporations just don't care. They have no clue and no awareness whatsoever about what effect they have on the market and on the world and on the economy. They'll do anything to make a profit, even if it means selling their first unborn child. And so they're rated anywhere between triple C to B. The next one is average, which is exactly what it sounds like. So if you're a student in school, you get a C+. Hi. Now this is rated anywhere between double B, triple B, and A. And this is exactly what it sounds. It's just average in the industry, but A is on the higher end of that scale, so it's pretty good. And the last one we have are the industry leaders, and they're rated from double A to triple A. And these companies are very socially aware of the effects that they have on the environment and the world. And here's how the rating works. For example, the E stands for environmental, and it looks for how the company affects the earth. And there's a lot of research that goes into this, but part of it includes things like greenhouse gas emissions, their climate change policies, their carbon footprints, their water-related goals, their renewable energy goals, whether they recycle or not, and how close they are with the EPA, and how open they are with disclosing all of this information with us, the public. Now the S stands for social, which focuses more on people or employees and the overall culture of the company. And it looks at things like the overall pay, the benefits, what the turnover rate is like, and how important is it to that company to hire people that are ethnically diverse. Does the company look diverse, or does it look like a bunch of people that look like me? And do they have a higher purpose other than just corporate profit and making their investors rich? For example, Elon Musk and Tesla, their goal beyond just the money aspect is to help humanity travel farther and more sustainably. So does that company have an ethos, or does it really just only care about making money? And the last one, the G, stands for... Just kidding. just wanted you to stay awake. The G stands for corporate governance, and basically it looks at a company's decision-making abilities. Does it make decisions based on long-term growth that's good for the world, or does it make decisions based on short-term opportunities just to make money? It also looks at whether or not a company pays out what's called the golden parachute, which is when a company pays millions and millions of dollars to senior executives for just retiring, leaving the company, and it just makes them rich. The other thing it looks at is whether or not the chairman and the CEO are the same position or are they two different things. Because when you're the CEO, you have a vision, a dream, a goal that you want to see achieved. And when you're the chairman, your goal is to just please investors and create more shareholder value. And the last thing it looks at is whether or not the company is close and friends with the SEC. So it's a very diverse model, and ESG covers a lot of things that looks at a company's ethics. But of course, no company is ever gonna be perfect. To find the perfect company would take months and months of research to put together this video and a list for you, and ain't nobody got time for that, especially when you're trying to upload 3 videos a week. But think about this, it would be so difficult to find a company with not only a high ESG rating, but also a company that's very profitable as well, because you don't just want to invest in green companies that don't make any money. Because imagine how difficult it is to try to figure out which technology is going to shape the future of humanity. Is it going to be fusion, hydropower, electric cars, or maybe you guessed right and it was solar panels? But do you really think that you're gonna guess which company is going to be the most successful solar panel company? Probably not. Statistically speaking, you're not gonna guess right. So I'm not gonna sit here and tell you exactly which specific list of stocks to invest in, because I don't want you to go out there and invest your hard-earned money and lose it all just because you watched some random guy on YouTube mentioning these stocks, and he had a lot of subscribers, so he must know what he's talking about. But I did promise a stock, so I will mention one that I don't feel bad at all mentioning just because it's been doing really, really well and it has this ESG rating in mind. And that stock is an ETF with the ticker symbol ESGV. Now, ESGV is Vanguard's exchange-traded fund that tracks small, medium, and large cap companies that fit within the ESG criteria. Except what it excludes are companies in the adult entertainment world, tobacco, alcohol, weapons, fossil fuels, gambling, and nuclear energy. So basically, all the fun profitable ones. No, I'm just kidding. It actually does have some great profitable companies, most of which I own, because its top 10 holdings are Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, Tesla, Visa, Procter & Gamble, MasterCard, Nvidia, and Home Depot. In fact, when compared to the golden standard of index investing, the best stock in that entire category is VTI. And if we compare ESGV against that, ESGV has actually done better. In the last year, VTI has done 14.73%, which is still really good. But ESGV has done 20.36%, which is substantially better. And data on this ETF doesn't go back farther than 3 years because it's pretty new, but it'll still be really interesting to keep an eye on this ETF just to see if socially responsible investing is better than just the overall stock market. But remember, owning one share of ESGV is gonna allow you to own 1,478 stocks, but if you wanna pick ESGV over VTI just because of the ESG rating, just remember they have an identical ESG rating of A, so they're basically extra average, which is really good because I'm the best at being average. Now, I don't own this specific ETF, but I do own most of the companies in the top 10 inside the ETF. But call me crazy, my theory is that companies on the opposite side of the spectrum, companies like Chevron, Shell, BP, ExxonMobil, those are the ones that stand to grow a lot, because not only do you have to look at companies that are going to profit from a greener future, but also companies that stand to lose the most. And the ones that stand to lose the most right now are the energy companies. And they have all the energy, the resources, the money to reinvent themselves and pivot and find a new business model that takes advantage of this brighter future. And if they don't do that, then they're gonna go extinct. So I'm gonna cross my fingers that they can do that in the next 10 years, or that the price of oil per barrel triples, because I'm a hypocrite and the ends justify the means. I'm just kidding, please don't hurt me. Now, I would personally love to have Robinhood, Webull, or M1 Finance include this ESG rating as a feature inside the brokerage. I know it's gonna cost them more money, so if they wanna include it in their premium service or gold service or whatever it is, I still think that would be awesome because I wanna know where my money is going and what social impact it has on the world. And I think that it makes for better investors anyway, because when you start investing, even if you don't look at the numbers of a company, then you're less likely to sell a stock if you know your why. If you know why you invested in it, because you're trying to create a better, brighter future for future generations, then you're less likely to sell a stock and panic and get out because you have your reason why you're gonna stick with it. And I know that this video is probably not gonna do anything, but I will leave a link down below this video to a petition in change.org where you could just leave your signature there and maybe one of these brokerages notices that, and if they could implement that feature, I think that would be super cool. Now, if you're still on the fence about starting to invest, I feel you, we are in the same boat because the time between September to October has typically been a pretty volatile time to invest. And that's because I've been really keeping track on the Pokemon card market lately, and this one card right here, the Charizard Pokemon card in first edition base set Shadowless, pristine PSA 10 condition, was selling 6 months to a year ago for $70,000, approximately. And I talked myself out of buying one. My friend Graham Stefan really wanted to get one, but now this same card can be seen listed on eBay for $300,000. And I know that's a silly example, like, okay, Pokemon cards, that's your economic indicator?
Idiot.
But this is true of every asset class. Whether it's the collectibles market or the stock market or real estate, everything is going up. Why though? Because we have Papa Powell injecting liquidity into the market so we can speed up the velocity of money, which judges how quickly we exchange money and get the economy going. So I try not to time the market. In fact, I made a video recently comparing what would happen if you timed the market perfectly over 41 years and you did that 5 times and succeeded versus just investing every single month, regardless of what happens in the market. And the results are super cool. But if there's ever a time to really be cautious, at least for me, it's to see what happens in the November elections. Because if anything triggers a stock market decline, it's probably going to be because of so much uncertainty. I don't know the answer to what is the best, most socially responsible way of investing, but technically living in a first world is not a good thing because we have insane demand for food and energy, and I don't know where you like to draw your invisible line in the sand about what you think is the most socially responsible answer, so I'm not gonna judge you for how you like to invest, but I'm just glad that there's something like the ESG rating to keep us socially responsible and at least aware of what's going on. So definitely sign that petition below in the link, because I don't think anything's gonna happen, but at least we could say we tried. And in the meantime, while you're doing that, don't forget to pick up your 2 free stocks, one from Webull by funding your account $100. You'll be able to get a free stock valued up to $1,600. You can get another free stock from Robinhood. Follow me on Instagram, I post from time to time. Join my free Discord group. Love you, thank you so much for watching the video. I will see you back here on Monday and Friday. And of course, sometimes a Wednesday, I'd love to hear your thoughts about your green stocks and if that's something that is important to you, but I guess we'll find out in the petition. Love you, bye-bye.